Now that we know how to hijack a request and respond with something basic, let's do something cooler. Let's go to the network for the response, but not for the thing that was requested. Handily, there's an API for that. Fetch. Fetch lets you make network requests and lets you read the response. Now, you might be thinking, isn't this what XML HTTP request is for? No, just no. Much of the XHR API is 15 years old. Soon it'll be old enough to drink, and I can't even bear to think of what a drunk XHR could do. Even from the outset, it wasn't particularly well thought out. I mean, just look at the name.
XML?
No, it deals with many different response types. HTTP? Not really. It deals with other protocols, such as file system. Request? Actually, the returned object is like a strange mixture of request and response. And why is the XML in all caps, but only the H in HTTP? But it's not just the name that's wrong. Here's the code to fetch some JSON from URL foo. Everything feels like it's in the wrong order. The URL's down there. You have to open and then send for some reason. It makes you declare how the response is read before you make the request. And it doesn't support lower level things like streams. But worst of all, the event system gets you into callback hell. Here's the fetch code for the same operation. Fetch foo. This returns a promise which resolves to a response. Then we can read that response as JSON. And then we've got the result. And we can catch errors from either the request or reading a response. Done. And as it turns out, back in our service worker, event.respondWith takes either a response or a promise that resolves to a response. Fetch returns a promise that resolves to a response, so they compose together really well. So let's respond with a fetch for a GIF. Over in the browser, let's enable force update, hit refresh, and we've just served up different content using the network. The fetch API performs a normal browser fetch, so the results may come from the cache. That's a benefit in this case, as we want the GIF to cache as usual.
Of course, we might not want to hijack every URL. We could... Oh, wait a minute, we have a incoming communication situation.
It is I, Mike Wales.
Hey Mike, so what's the meaning of this interruption?
Well, it sounded like you were just going to describe a load of stuff, but I think it'd be better if the students figured this out for themselves.
Great idea, go for it.